Since we started the On Two Wheels and Four Paws video series about traveling on adventure motorcycles with our German Shepherd Moxie, the most common question we receive from hardcore moto guys and gals is about motorbike maintenance. And by the way, this was also the most frequent question on our old Rough on the Road YouTube channel, especially since those travel videos tended to involve Greg doing a lot of off-road crashing. So, since Greg carries the tools on his bike and does most of the crashing and the wrench work, I'm handing this topic over to him.
Yeah, so right off the bat, I need to state that I'm far from a competent mechanic. You can tell that just by how long the basic maintenance and servicing projects take me. That said, the need to deal with the occasional and always inopportune breakdown or crash damage has forced me to spend some time on this issue. Between the digital version of the service manual, the servicing classes that some dealerships offer, and all the how-tos on YouTube and the forums, the biggest question for me was how to store my tools on the bike. So that's what I want to share here. The toolkit for my BMW F700GS includes the RT-B1 Road Tech BMW toolkit from Cruz Tools. To this, I've added a few additional Allens, Torxes, and wrenches that correspond to the aftermarket accessories. I've also added a travel roll of duct tape. In case you haven't seen this done before, it's really easy. Wind the tape from a standard roll around a plastic straw until you have the length that you need. Then just cut the ends off the straw. I've also added zip ties, plenty of zip ties. If you can't do it with zip ties, duct tape, and WD-40. Then there's a small Ziploc filled with spare nuts, bolts, and washers. There's the tubeless puncture pilot and mini air compressor kit from Stop & Go. And lastly, there's a Leatherman multi-tool. Although I rarely ride without the panniers, it was really important to me that the tools could all be permanently stored on the bike so that I would never accidentally leave home without them or occupy valuable luggage space. I originally installed one of those plastic tool tubes, the ones that are essentially a repurposed manual canister, like what you find on bulldozers and tractors. The tool tube wasn't waterproof, and the mounting tabs couldn't support the load through potholes and rocky terrain. Then I found the aluminum adventure tool tube from Moto Arbo in the UK. The thing is waterproof and bombproof. It's indestructible, but it's also heavy. So after building a mount that secures to the inside of the pannier rack, I decided I didn't like that much additional load on the rack, especially with full panniers. For whatever reason, the mounting rack for the Touratech Ziga Pro panniers doesn't use the mounting points on the chassis that BMW uses for its own Vario pannier system. So what I came up with is a purpose-built standalone rack that secures to those mounting points on the chassis. Another good thing about the 40 and 50 millimeter versions of the Adventure tool tube are the two instead of one mounting tabs. With 8 screws and some Loctite, it might as well be welded onto the chassis. Unfortunately, the tool tube doesn't come with a form-fitting tool bag. So I brought some 1000D Cordura to an upholsterer here in Guatemala and had a tool bag made. It's got pull tabs at both ends, 3M reflective along the length, and a white vinyl interior to maintain its shape and make finding loose bits a bit easier. Yeah, so reach out to me if you're interested. I've got a bunch. The spare nuts and bolts fit in the tubeless puncture pilot kit. The kit goes into a lightweight waterproof sack and fits into the shallow cutout in the underside of the seat. The cutout originally has two plastic tabs. I think it's intended for a first aid kit. I cut away the two tabs and secured the kit in place with a couple of double-sided Velcro bands. A little further down on the underside of the seat, there's another cutout that holds a few road tools. I removed the tools and secured the Leatherman multi-tool in their place with an elastic. Last but not least, I placed the mini air compressor in another lightweight waterproof sack and stored it in the cubby hole under the passenger seat and luggage rack. I think this is originally intended for the owner's manual. In order for the compressor to fit, you have to remove a small sensor that's clipped down in the center of the cubby hole. Once you unclip it, you can zip tie the sensor along with some other wires that run along the chassis on either side. I line the bottom with a small microfiber just to give a little cushion and to fill in any gaps so that the compressor can't rub or jostle around. If you're using the Stop & Go mini compressor, you'll find there's even still some room on either side to store replacement bulbs if you're not running LEDs.
We hope you guys found this interesting and useful. Be sure to tune in and subscribe to our Moto Travel Adventures with German Shepherd Moxie on two wheels and four paws.